If you had published this review a year ago, there's a good chance that you wouldn't be watching it. In fact, there's a good chance that we wouldn't be reviewing this bike at all. With the petrol prices touching close to the 100 mark, we are in search of an alternate source of fuel for our mobility. That's where the Ampere Magnus Pro comes into picture. An easy solution for electric mobility in terms of two-wheelers. So coming back to the bigger question, how much will you save on your fuel bills if you opt for this electric mobility in terms of the Ampere Pro? So let's take this classic example. There are two driving modes, one is the low and one is the high mode. In low mode, the bike should go somewhere around 70 kilometers, but in the high mode, the bike should go somewhere around 60 kilometers. So let's take the lower cut here, that is a 60 kilometer. And for that, for the full range of 60 kilometers, you would have to charge your bike full for close to 6 hours. And for that, it's going to consume close to 2 units of electricity. And 2 units of electricity typically cost around 11 to 12 rupees in a typical domestic household, which translates to 20 paisa per kilometer of running cost. But on the contrary, a typical 100cc or 125cc scooter should give you a mileage of 40 km per litre, which translates to the running cost of 2 rupees 30 paisa per kilometer, assuming the fuel price is approximately 90 rupees. This is less than 1/10 of the cost. Is it worth it? Definitely yes.
Ampere has tried to take the conventional route while designing the Magnus Pro. It's one of those eco-friendly scooters that look quite similar to a conventional scooter, unlike the radical design of Ather. It comes packaged with energy-saving LED headlamps and tail lamps. In case you wonder why most of the electric bikes use LEDs instead of classic halogens, the Magnus Pro comes with a thick V-shaped chrome element which integrates with the large pair of turn indicators. You get the dedicated pocket storage in the front which hosts a direct USB port to charge your phone or any other gadget. The seat offers good amount of cushioning which keeps both rider and passenger seated comfortably even on slightly longer journeys. The Magnus Pro is provided with a digital instrument cluster which is bright and well readable. But we really wish we got the percentage display for the battery rather than the volts, which was unreliable in some instances and showed inconsistent reading. It has a payload capacity of up to 150 kgs, which is quite impressive for such a lightweight scooter. Talking of the charger, it's a simple 3-point pin which you can hook to any 3-pin socket in your home. The other end of the wire has to be connected to a round port in front of the scooter as shown here. The scooter is very silent and makes absolutely no noise when it's on the move, unlike the Ather which gets very vocal. Our experience on bumpy roads was honestly bad. The telescopic forks at the front and the coil springs at the rear have been too stiff and can cause discomfort while riding. You will relate to it better if you have to tackle infinite potholes or the treacherous terrains of Bangalore's urban roads. The scooter itself weighs just over 85 kgs, making it extremely lightweight and is very easy to ride. Being lightweight, the Magnus Pro also can be thrown around corners with ease and can get out of tight spaces very well. But the biggest turnoff was the ultra light and sensitive handlebar of the scooter, which can cause nervousness in high speeds or decent city speed maneuvers. Just like the sensitive steerings of Hyundai for your reference. The Ampere Magnus Pro, being a premium flagship model, claims to offer strong performance, extended range and loads of modern day features to stay in the game. With the rising fuel prices, if you're looking for a budget friendly scooter, we still feel Optima HX will attract you as it's cheaper. But if you don't mind burning a slight hole in your pocket for the additional features and a much better braking, then the Ampere Pro steals the show without a second thought.
The coolest part about the scooter is the battery is removable. You can remove it like this, unhook a couple of screws here and take it home and charge it and get it back the next day. It's going to be very convenient, especially for people who are living in apartments where it's not convenient to charge the bike directly. And on the contrary, it's slightly difficult to remove it. It's not at all easy and it's even more difficult to put it back. We had the Hero Optima HX where it's much easier to remove the battery there and put it back. And you have the light here. It's very convenient at night to search for anything that you kept here. If you're worried about leaving the electric scooter for a longer duration, say close to a month, and then coming back, and if you're concerned if the charge is going to drop down, that can be avoided if you switch off the MCB board here. What happens is, once you switch off the MCB board, the charge is going to remain same for a couple of days. For example, if you leave it at 72%, it's going to remain at 72% after you come back. So this is the charger. It typically takes around close to 6 hours to full charge the bike, and you have two options here. One is the charging and second is the charging completed mode. There's no progressive charging bar here, as in you won't get to know how much the bike is charged, like 25%, 30% or whatever. You just get two options here, whether it's charging or charging is completed. I really wish the under seat storage space was slightly better, because right now it cannot accommodate a full face helmet. So this is a full face helmet here, but probably can accommodate a half face helmet, but not a full face helmet here. So this is the key fob of the Amper Magnus Pro. It's pretty cool. In fact, it's a remote key. You have the typical couple of options here. That is the lock. So this is the unlock. And one interesting feature is, in case you are in the parking lot and not able to find where your scooter is, you can just press this button. It's going to signal that I'm here. So here's one feature which I think should be adapted to other scooters as well. This is the anti-theft alarm. In case you try to sneak into the scooter without the key, this is what's going to happen. A bit too cheesy, but very helpful. So another safety feature here is so turn on the ignition, and no matter how much throttle input I give, the bike is not going to move unless until you turn off the parking brake. So turn it off now and the bike will move now. Very interesting. If you guys like the video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram. Take care, drive safe, and more importantly, stay healthy.